Welcome to Gustavus Adolphus College and Christmas in Christ Chapel 2022, Celestial Wonder, Joy Unfolding. Tonight, 350 of our talented students will showcase their gifts to help us celebrate Christmas. This year, the service will focus on Mary, the mother of Jesus, and her cousin Elizabeth, the mother of John the Baptist. Thank you to all of the donors who have established endowments to support this event, including Randall Schreiner and Cynthia Bittner, Sandra and Dan Buendorf, Patricia Haugen, Daniel and Nova Colander, and Ray Lundquist and the late Lorraine Lundquist. And a special thanks to John and Anita Young and their Heroic Productions team. May this service leave you with wonder, joy, and hope. Have a blessed and happy holiday season. And now, please sit back, relax, and enjoy Christmas in Christ Chapel.
Holy sages once did sing that he, our deadly forfeit, should release and with his Father work us a perpetual peace.
Thank you.
triangle table to sit the midst of trinal unity. He laid aside, and here, with us to be, forsook the everlasting courts of day, and chose with us a darksome house of mortal clay. Such music, as 'tis said, before was never made. But when of old the sons of morning sung, while the Creator, great, his constellations set, and the well-balanced world on hinges hung, and cast the dark foundations deep, and bid the weltering waves their oozy channel keep.
Thank you. Creation begins with a breath. The spirit's wind moving over waters and the deep. Not only once in long ago, but time and again through every chapter of formless void. She blows through limits and less thans to declare what should be a symphony of both. Light and darkness, dawn and dusk, chrome and compass of God's manifold image, the treasures and darkness aglow. Male and female, the fullness of being, so good and enough from the start. Creation begins with a breath. Snuffing out candles of category, claims about who can tell its slant. Who can bear the full weight of the word made flesh?
Tear, tear, tear. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month for her who is said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Anima meatum, anima meatum, anima meatum, anima meatum, anima meatum, anima meatum.
In those days, Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leapt for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord."
Thank you.
Can you hear Elizabeth's blessing? She opens the door so wide and hard the hinges wince. Her bold voice is prophetic delight for every ear, while the men nearby remain quiet, silent, sleeping, and not yet sure. Can you hear Mary laughing? It shakes her belly and her thighs. It rumbles in her muscles and her milk. She has felt the full weight, and she let him go for the whole world. There is room in the chariot for the full spectrum of beauty, like watercolors expanding, taking up space and announcing new life, even now, even now.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I'm bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger."
Thank you. Thank you. When the song of the angels is stilled, when the star in the sky is gone, when the kings and princes are home, when the shepherds are back with their flock, the work of Christmas begins. To find the lost, to heal the broken, to feed the hungry, to release the prisoner, to rebuild the nations, to bring peace among others, to make music in the heart.
Dwelling place, O Lord of hosts.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder, for the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor you have broken, as on the day of Midian. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Thank you.
Creator of the universe, we call out to you in praise and in prayer. Who are we that this glorious form, light of hope and wisdom of darkness, would be mindful of us? In holy wonder, we give thanks for your works made manifest this night, for melody, word, and dance shared in the sacredness of this gathered community. Tonight, with the joy of Mary and Elizabeth echoing in our hearts, women who dared to speak of hope in the midst of the impossible, who welcomed the cosmic into their wombs and birthed a new way into all of creation.